Deadly Tarantula Girl coming to you from... Deadly Tarantula Girl coming to you from the wild outdoors to bring you part two of my miniature horse series. It's been a little while since I've put out a miniature horse video and things have just been busy. I actually need to film a tomahawk update, who is my little male. Now he has a beautiful bride to call his very own. This is a lovely pinto or paint filly. She is a year and a half old, same age as Tomahawk, and I'm hoping that one day they will have a little colt of their own. She's absolutely beautiful. She has brown eyes. She's white and brown with a bicolored mane. This little girl was born at a miniature horse farm out of Carlsbad, New Mexico, and she was bred by some really, really nice people who were just downsizing their farm. And so I was very, very lucky because the woman decided to keep her. And then once we did a little bit of visiting, decided that she would let this beauty come home with me. This little girl is about 29 inches tall and she's absolutely beautiful. She has lovely conformation, a nice build, four white stockings, and a little white heart under her forelock. So that's just really special. I've always wanted to paint. I had standard horses when I was a little girl, but always wanted miniature horses. And that dream wasn't fulfilled until I was an adult. Although I love reptiles and tarantulas, I also love mammals too. You guys have probably seen my dogs a little bit. Some of my miniature pig videos. I do have a trio of miniature pigs that actually had two lovely litters of piglets this summer. And so my next venture is miniature horses. I'm very, very excited about this. Miniature horses are not for riding, as you might imagine. They are much smaller and finer boned than a Shetland pony. A miniature horse is actually a very tiny version of a horse. Ponies are shorter and stockier, while horses are taller but finer boned. And a miniature horse is just what it sounds. Basically, a teeny tiny version of a standard horse. I think they're really beautiful. They have nice personalities. This little girl was very shy when we first brought her home, and every day she's coming around. Miniature horses are primarily used as companion animals, but can also be taught to pull carts or even drive buggies. Although they cannot bear a lot of weight on their backs, with harnesses, they can actually pull a surprising amount of weight. You want to make sure that you have a miniature horse harness and that your horse is harnessed properly, or you can injure your animal and strain their back. These animals are not work animals for me. They are simply companions, and I think they're absolutely beautiful. I enjoy coming out to groom them. I take them for walks. We have a miniature horse down the street that they like to go and visit. His name is Rowdy, and he's quite a handsome fellow. This is one of my dream come true, being a miniature horse owner, and I just wanted to share my beautiful new little girl with you. She does need a name, so if you have any ideas, I would love to hear them. My other horse's name is Tomahawk, and she's kind of wild and free-spirited. So if you have any ideas, I would love to hear them. I hope you guys like this one, and if you're waiting for tarantulas, that'll be coming up soon. I guess she is done being on camera, and I'll see you guys next time.